Jesse Miller and Barbara Balestra are at the Anacostia River just west of Washington, D.C. Their mission is to check the water and sediment for microplastics.
How long have you been monitoring this river?
Well, at this site, probably 2.5 or 3 years.
Yeah,
there we are, sir.
But
we've done other sites on the river for longer than.
But it's like we come 4 times a year, like every season.
There is no shortage. They find microplastics at almost all their sampling sites, regardless of season and location. From here on the eastern shore of the United States to the farmlands of Europe and to the rivers and seas of Asia, our food chain is pervaded with microplastics, plastic particles and fiber measuring less than 8 millimeters across, broken down, of course, from macroplastic. A 2019 World Wildlife Fund study concluded that we ingest an average of 5 grams of plastic, the equivalent of 1 credit card, every week. Even here in Rock Creek Park in Washington, D.C., there is plastic waste, which hiker Rachel Hunt collects on her walks.
This is easy to do. I can get this in a 1-hour walk. It's everywhere.
The supply of plastic has not diminished, and 45% of all plastic is used in packaging. How does one stem the tide of microplastics? Reduce it at the source.
Move away from single-use plastics where possible, especially with food packaging and items that don't need to be single-use glass. And I think there's hope there too, because there are definitely places that have put into place policies, some bans and some reductions in use of single-use plastics. And so I think there's a message of hope there also.
Nirmal Ghosh, The Straits Times, in Bladensburg, Maryland.